Right. Hopefully you have already gone over my video on what a term is and what a like term is, because now we're going to simplify expressions by combining like terms. So for instance, if we have, let's say, 7x plus 3x squared plus 8x plus 10x squared, combining like terms, well, what does that mean? We need to see terms that are alike. That means the variable part is exactly the same. So in the first term, we have a 7x. So we look, is there anything else that has exactly the same variable part? And here it's an x. This is an x squared. That's different. But over here, I have an 8x. So these are exactly the same. So if you want, you don't need to write this step out, but I'm going to combine those together because it's like, well, I have 7 of these objects and 8 more of these objects. Also, I have a 3x squared. I see if there's another x squared term, and here we are. So by an x squared term, I'm looking for something that has the same variable part. So I can combine those together as well. So I've got 7 of these x's plus 8 more of these x's. That's 15 of them. And I've got 3 of these x squares. That's like a different kind of animal. And 10 of these x squares, that would be 13x squared. And these cannot be combined any further. Those are different animals, different fruit, completely different things. All right, let's say we're doing similar, like if I'm going to say I'm going to add 3 feet plus 2 inches plus 5 feet plus 9 inches. It's really similar to that. I'm really just combining like terms when I add these two to get 8 feet. And then I'm adding the other two to get 11 inches. And then we'd have 8 feet, 11 inches is how we would usually write this. But the way I'm doing this algebraically is we're adding them together. Now, they don't have to be whole numbers. You still are just going to combine the coefficient. So let's say you had 5.3 m squared plus 1.4 m squared. These are like terms because they're both m squares. So I add the 5.3 and the 1.4 to get 6.7 m squared. So notice you just write exactly the same variable part down, but you add the coefficients. Do not add the exponents or multiply the exponents. It's still m squared. You've got 5.3 of these things, right? And 1.4 of those things all together, I'm going to have 6.7 of exactly the same thing. And the same thing would go with fractions, but let's say you have like m squared over 2 plus m squared over 3, this is a little bit tricky. This is where you have to remember the coefficient here is 1/2, and the coefficient here is 1/3. And then, of course, you have to remember how to add fractions, and there are a lot of ways to do that. All right, see if you could remember how to add 1/2 plus 1/3, and see how you would write your final answer. All right, one way is getting a common denominator. So if I have 1/2, I need to multiply it by 3 over 3 to get a common denominator of 6. And 1/3, multiply by 2 over 2, so I have 3/6. This is just side work I'm doing. So 5/6 is what happens. This is sort of, you know, scratch work, right? You don't have to show all those steps. So that over here, when I add the 1/2 and 1/3, my answer is 5/6 m squared. Now, there are more ways to add fractions, but no matter how you do it, you're going to get 5/6 m squared. You might see that written as 5 m squared over 6. That's also completely correct. This is showing it as a coefficient times the variable part, and this is sort of like multiplying it 5/6 times m squared over 1 and just writing it as a single fraction. Both of those are completely correct. Let's look at this one. 9m squared n minus 3mn squared. So the question is, are these like terms? Well, over here I have an m squared, but over here I only have an m, so no. You have to have exactly the same exponent on whatever variables there are. So this is simplified, and you can't combine like terms. All right, what about 9m squared n minus 3nm squared? Are these like terms? Well, I've got an m squared and an n, and over here I have an n and an m squared. Those are exactly the same, and this is why if I have more than one variable in a term, I write them in alphabetical order. And if you write them in alphabetical order, just using the commutative property, remember n times m squared could be written as m squared times n, then it's easy to see that these really are exactly the same variable part. So then I could do 9 minus 3, which is 6, m squared n. All right, here are three problems for you to try on your own. Go ahead and put it on pause. Try it, and we'll come back and see how you did. All right, the first one. I'm looking for common variable parts. So I have a 5x squared. Is there another x squared? Yes. And make sure you pay attention to the sign. It's minus 4, so you have to combine the 5 minus 4 to get 1x squared. And we don't write 1 for a final answer. So even though you might first write 1x squared, later you're going to take off the 1 to be more simplified, because 1 times anything is really whatever that other part is. I also have the like terms right here, the negative 3x and the negative 8x, so I have to combine those like terms. That'll give you a minus 11x. My final answer should be written as x squared minus 11x. That's the most simplified way to write it. So even though you might put a 1 in front of it for yourself, as you're going along working problems, for final answers, you don't leave a 1 in front of variables. All right, let's go on to the next one. All right, I have to look for like terms. So here is an x squared y. So we have to see, is there any other place where there's an x squared y? It's right here. I have a y times x squared. That's the same thing as an x squared times y. This other one, I do not have an x squared, so that is not a common term. So it's not a like term. So we're going to add these two together. Negative 8 plus 3, adding the coefficients, is negative 5. And then you just write the variable part down again, which is negative 5x squared. And I have this plus 4xy squared that I don't combine with anything else because there's no other like terms with that. All right, and the last one. Right, I have a 5xy, and I'm looking for another 5xy. I've got a negative 5xy. That's 0xy. You don't write 0. 0 times anything is 0. So that term adds up to 0. And then what do I have? I have a 2x plus a 3y. Those are different completely. So the answer to this is just 2x plus 3y. All right, here's two more to try. This first one going to be x plus x plus x plus x plus x. Hey, I've got 5 of the same things. Or think of adding the 5 coefficients of 1. Answer is 5x. Not so bad. All right, let's do the next one. These are all the same variable parts too. I got am, 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 am. Remember, that's really like a 1 for this last one. So what would that be? Well, you've got 11 plus 3 plus 7, that's 21, minus 1, you should get 20 a.m. All right, so that's how you combine like terms and simplify as much as possible. Have fun. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.